If your God of War Ragnarok won't launch, or crashing after launch, here are a few methods that could help you fix this problem. I was doing some research over the internet, and will show you methods that helped people to fix their game with one of the methods. I don't have God of War Ragnarok in my Steam library, but that is not stopping me to show you all the methods that could really help you. So let's go with the first one. As always, I would suggest you to restart your PC, if you haven't already, and try to launch the game. Many PC problems are solved with one simple restart, so try it. And if that didn't help, you can continue with the next methods. Next one is to run Steam as admin. First, make sure that Steam is not running. Click on this arrow in System Tray. Right-click on Steam, and select Exit Steam. Find Steam shortcut on your desktop. Right-click on it, and select Properties. Select Compatibility tab up here, and make sure that this box next to Run this program as administrator is checked. This setting gives Steam some extra permissions, and I would suggest you to leave it that way all the time. Hit Apply and OK. Launch Steam and check did this worked. For next method, you need to go into God of War. If you don't know where to find it, launch Steam, and go to Steam Library. On the left side, find God of War. Right-click on it, and select Properties. As I said, I don't own the game, so as an example I will use Apex Legends to show you what you need to do. On the left side menu, you will click on Installed Files, and then click here on Browse. This will take you to God of War Install folder. You will find game .exe file. Like you see, this is Apex executable file, where it says Application, under the type. Right-click on it, and select Properties. Click on Compatibility tab, and here, check this box next to Run this program as an administrator. Hit Apply, and OK. Launch the game and see did this worked. If your game crashing or you getting black screen, you can also check this box, next to Disable Full Screen Optimizations. Then check this box next to Run this program in compatibility mode for. And then in this drop-down menu, select Windows 8. Save these changes, and try the game. For next method, you need to go to Game Properties again. Select Installed Files. And here you'll see the option Verify Integrity of Game Files. Click on it, and wait for all files to be scanned. If any game files are missing or corrupted, this scan will identify them and download missing files or replace corrupted ones. Don't interrupt this process. After it finishes, launch the game. Next is to allow God of War through Windows Firewall. Before we go into Firewall settings, click again here on Browse. Now click here on Empty Spot in the address bar. And when you see entire address is selected like this, right-click on it, and select Copy. You will need this for next step. You can now close this window. Click on Start, and type Windows Defender. Select Windows Defender Firewall up here. On the left side, select Allow an app or feature through Windows Defender Firewall. Scroll through this list of apps, and find God of War. If you can find it, make sure that these two boxes are checked, under Private and Public. For this, you will first click on Change Settings. And now you can check both boxes. After that, click on OK, and check did this worked. If you can't find God of War here, in this list, then you will have to add it. To do that, click on Allow Another App. Then Browse. Now click up here on Empty Spot. And delete all this. Then right-click, select Paste, and hit Enter. You will be in Game Installation folder. Find that God of War .exe file. Click on it, and then select Open. Here click on Add, and all you need to do now, is to find the game, and check that two boxes. Hit OK after that, and check did this worked. Next is to set God of War to high priority in graphic settings. Click on Start, type Graphic Settings, and select it. If you don't have hardware accelerated GPU scheduling enabled, enable it now. This option improves latency and game performance. You'll need to restart your PC for these settings to take effect, but don't do it yet. Click on Browse. And then click here on Empty Spot in Address Bar. When the address is highlighted, press Backspace on your keyboard to delete it. Then right-click in the address bar, select Paste, and hit Enter. Click once on God of War EXE file. Then click on Add down here. Find it in the list. Click on it, and select Options. Here, choose High Performance, and then Save. Now you can restart your computer. After rebooting, launch the game and check if it works. Next thing you will do, is perform a clean boot. Right-click on Start and select Run. Type misconfig in search box and hit Enter. This window will open. And make sure you are on Services tab. Check this box where it says, Hide all Microsoft services. Click here on Disable all. Click Apply and OK, and it will ask you to restart your Windows. Restart it and launch the game. If you could launch the game normally, it means that some of the programs listed here is interfering with the game, and prevent it to launch normally. So if the game launch, you will come here again and enable one by one app from the list. Restart Windows after that, and launch the game until you find out what app is causing launch failure. Then you can decide do you want uninstall it or just disable it to launch with your Windows, so you can start your game with no problems. It's crucial to have the latest GPU drivers and ensure your Windows is up to date, as outdated versions can cause the game to fail to launch. To update your graphic card driver, right-click on Start. Select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters. Right-click on your display adapter, and select Update Driver. Choose Search Automatically for Drivers. If Windows finds and installs an update, restart your PC, and then launch the game. Even if there are no updates here, I recommend visiting your GPU manufacturer's website, finding your graphic card, and downloading the latest driver. Install software from your manufacturer's page, whether you have AMD, Intel, or NVIDIA GPU. For example, I have NVIDIA graphic card, so I installed the NVIDIA GeForce Experience software. Launch it. Click on Drivers. And then check for updates. As you see down here, my driver is up to date. But if there's an update, you will install it in just two clicks. And this software will even notify you with a pop-up message when you have new driver available. So, download this software to save time and trouble. Next, check if your Windows is up to date. Click on Start. Select Settings. Then Update and Security. Click on Check for Updates. If Windows offers any new updates, download and install them. After that, restart your PC and launch the game. And here are some additional options if none of the above worked. If you installed custom antivirus software, temporarily disable it to ensure it's not interfering with the game or Steam, and then launch the game to check that. If you use Discord, listen to music through apps or your web browser, use any kind of overlays, or have other apps running, close them. Any additional apps running alongside the game take up CPU and GPU resources and could be why your game crashes. In short, close all apps you don't need while gaming. If your game crashes during gameplay, check if the hard drive where the game is installed is full, as this can cause crashes. Transferring the game to another drive, especially from a normal hard drive to an SSD, could work. If you follow all these steps exactly as I've shown you, your game should be fixed with no more crashes. With this, we've come to the end of this video. If any of these methods worked for you, please hit that like button, and consider subscribing to my channel for more useful videos like this one. Until the next video, stay safe, happy gaming, and I'll see you all.